So this is the file which contains all the important topics for NABARD. There are a total of 22 topics as you can see here, and I have picked up these topics on my own from a variety of sources, from a variety of expected topics that are expected to be asked in the examination this year. Some of them are very popular, some of them are less popular but more important. So let's just discuss all these topics very briefly one by one. And from tomorrow, I will start with discussing all these topics one by one in detail, so that you are able to prepare for these topics in a much more better and advanced manner. The first topic talks about the role of food processing industry in Indian agriculture. Food processing has time and again been promoted by the government, and the present government is promoting it and pushing it even further. And therefore, its linkage with Indian agriculture and how it can contribute to growth, to the overall growth of the economy as well as to the growth of Indian agriculture, that becomes important. And that is why I have framed this essay. Is MSP still relevant in ensuring farmer welfare? Now, this topic is important for the simple reason that we have been fighting in WTO over not eliminating subsidies in the form of MSP and other subsidies that are being provided to Indian farmers for their welfare. How can India balance between WTO rules on subsidies and the need to support Indian farmers through direct and indirect monetary support? This is again flowing from the same issue, WTO. What steps have been taken to enhance institutional credit in agriculture? This is relevant for both NABARD as well as RBI examination, because herein we are talking about the importance of institutional credit in promoting or in growth of agriculture in India. So what steps have been taken to enhance institutional credit in agriculture? Let it be Kisan credit card, let it be cooperatives, growth of cooperatives, let it be regional rural banks, let it be payment banks and small finance banks. All these are methods of promoting institutional credit in agriculture. Let it be the interest subsidy schemes, interest subvention schemes, all those things are a part of this particular essay topic. Advantages and disadvantages of direct benefit transfer in agriculture. So DBT is a hot topic, and DBT in agriculture is even a more hot topic, because recently PM Kisan has announced 6,000 rupees in every farmer's account every year, and that is a form of DBT only, and therefore it becomes important. So instead of asking directly about PM Kisan, which is also a question here and here, I thought let's ask the same question indirectly by talking about the purpose of PM Kisan or the features of PM Kisan. How can farmer producer organizations benefit farming in India? The government presently is pushing farmer producer organizations very aggressively, and therefore they become very important from examination point of view. Role of NABARD in development of agriculture in India, a very static and a very cliche topic, but holds some importance for the interview as well, because you will be able to understand the role and the work of NABARD in development of agriculture in India. Alternative technologies for a climate change resilient India. Alternative technologies for a climate change resilient India. This is important because of recent drought situations in the country at many places, because of suddenly and consistently changing climate in the country on a wide scale, which is affecting agriculture at the very starting. So the first effect on it is on agriculture. Banking crisis in India, failure of governance and regulation. This is more relevant for RBI and less relevant for NABARD. Banking crisis in India, failure of governance and regulation. What is the role of technology in agriculture? So various technologies, various upcoming technologies, whether it's with respect to irrigation, drip irrigation and other kinds of irrigation, sprinkler, etc., whether it is the seeds, whether it is drought resistant varieties of seeds, whether it is the way organic farming is becoming more resilient and more popular through the usage of technology, whether it is indoor agriculture, which is a technology which is being taken or adopted from Israel. So all these technologies become very important and are certainly important for the examination. The root cause of agrarian distress in India, failure of policies or failure of governance. So this is also important because agrarian distress is still not resolved in India. It is still very much a part of Indian agriculture. What are the ways to overcome disguised unemployment in Indian agriculture? This I have discussed in the first topic also, food processing, how it affects or how it resolves the problem of disguised unemployment. And there are many other ways of overcoming disguised unemployment in Indian agriculture. I'm sure you are aware about all some of those methods, and you must be thinking about them right now as well. That's very good. Indian fertilizer industry has overlooked the aspects related to environmental pollution. How can the damage be undone for the sake of sustainable agriculture? Steps required to make agriculture in India more sustainable and profitable at the same time. So this is directly connected with doubling farmers' income. How can you double farmers' income? By increasing the profits of farmers, because farmer is not an employee, he's not getting salary from anywhere. You need to increase the profits of farmers in order to double their income. Okay. Impact of climate change on world food production, a global topic, not specific to India, a global topic here. PM Kisan, another topic here, a short-term populist move or a long-term structural change in the way government redistributes income, or in other words, in the way change in the way subsidies are being provided to the farmers in agriculture. Green revolution to evergreen revolution, what steps can ensure successful implementation of evergreen revolution? So what is the objective of evergreen revolution? What is the meaning or definition of evergreen revolution? And what steps are required to ensure successful implementation of evergreen revolution? How can organic farming be the new norm in Indian agriculture? So this is again a futuristic topic which talks about what needs to be done in order to make organic farming not a luxury, but something that is mandatory, a necessity, not a luxury. How can India stop migration of people from rural to urban areas? This particular topic is specific to rural development. Okay, so whether it's amenities of urban areas in rural areas, so rural, whether it is providing more income to farmers in agriculture, whether it is creating manufacturing and service facilities or industries in the rural sector, whether it is tourism, all these dimensions become important for stopping migration of people from rural to urban areas, and we need to talk about them. How can India become a crop exporting country by 2022? How can India become what? A crop exporting country by 2022. So this is also related with the WTO issue that India is facing, because majority of our production is still being utilized for domestic use. We are not able to export a lot of our agricultural products. Why? Because our intensity or our productivity of agriculture is very low. We have a large land base dependent on agriculture, but at the same time the productivity is very low and the quality of production is not aligned with the international requirements, and therefore exporting is affected. So what are the steps that are required to become a crop exporting country? Features of PM Kisan, a direct question, but very high chances of this being asked in the examination. And how can PM Kisan benefit farmers in the long run? So this is directly connected with this, the same question being framed in another way. So this is the way questions can be framed, essays can be framed and asked from you. I have tried to discuss majority of the topics related with Indian agriculture and rural development. If you have any more topics, feel free to provide them in the comment section below. I shall be starting with a discussion, detailed discussion of every topic one by one. I'll try and cover it on a daily basis, and the purpose is simple: to hit where it is most effective. And the area that can be most effective at this point of time is essay, is English. And therefore, we try and cover that as fast as possible, as effectively as possible. Okay? I hope you liked this lesson. If you did, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Also, press the bell icon if you liked it a lot. All the very best. Take care.